Okay, let me see if we're live. And yes, we are live, my friend. All right, let me go ahead and close this down. Cool, cool, cool. Make sure we have sound online. Sure we do. Yep, we have live. We have sound. All right. My man, Joseph Beavis. How you doing, bro?
All right, man. How you doing?
I'm great, man. I'm great, man. Congratulations, first of all and foremost, for becoming our newest Millionaire Circle Ring Earner, man. I'm very, very excited for you and your family.
Thanks, man.
Nah, it's all good. You know, it's interesting, right? We've had some people who are brand new with us, you know, who've gotten a ring. But they haven't made any, they probably haven't made anywhere near the money you guys have made, or your group has made, you know, since we've been on this journey for about a year now. And I'm excited for you, man. You have a lovely team. You guys are sharp. You know, it's always good to, you know, they reach out to me from time to time, and they always ask good questions. But then I always say, hey, you know, go ahead and ask Joe. And it's just a pleasure and a joy to work with you now for, it's been over a year now, right?
Right. I mean, our history's probably been 7 years, but here.
Yeah, exactly. Right? Yeah, our history's been a while, but with this platform, it's been, you know, about a year.
Right on.
Yeah, man. So let's jump into it. So Millionaire Club Circle, man, I'm excited. Now, what you're a family man, you're married with kids. Tell folks a little bit about yourself. So, you know, before I start hitting you with the hard questions.
Yeah, I got a 7-year-old and a 10-year-old, and, you know, both girls, and they just, you know, we're living that midlife in Wisconsin, you know, just, you know, taking it day by day and, you know, enjoying what we could do. And
cool.
Pretty much it, you know, nothing too exciting out here, just doing our thing.
Well, the fact that you're a girl dad, and I didn't know that, but bingo, I got on my girl dad shirt. You know, the fact that you're a girl dad, and you can't say living it day by day, it's exciting every darn day in this house anyway.
Right, really a 10-year-old. 10-year-old's a treat every day now.
Oh, man. I'm outnumbered. You know, we just got some boy dogs. We had girl dogs. We had some fish. They were girls, too. I was the only darn male in this house. So.
Yeah. We got one male dog. The rest is a male girl, male cat, male fish. I don't know who else. They might have more animals hiding in the room than females.
Oh, man. But this is great. So we've known each other now, you know, through different opportunities and stuff for what, about 4 or 5 years?
Yeah.
Wow. This is our first time doing it. We've talked through Facebook all the time. This is our first time, like, maybe our second time, like, doing a Zoom, right?
Yep, that's what happens when I call you the wrong name. I get to know you. That's how I met you. Yeah, it was funny, though. Good time.
That was, man. So, what do you do for a living? We have so many people with so many different backgrounds who are kicking butt with UIGI. But what's your profession? What do you do for a living?
Well, realistic, I'm an auto technician, and then I travel around doing motorcycle stunt shows during the basic Labor Day, Memorial Day, Labor Day, and, you know, traveling, doing that for 20 years. But, you know, if you want to say my day job, but I don't think I'm ever there. I'm actually an auto technician.
Wow, motorcycle stunt shows. It's funny. I'm from the hood, right? And so back in the day, you know, Guy Ritchie sold DMX. Man, Rough Riders. Say it again.
That's where it started, dude. When I saw Week 1100 in that Rough Rider video riding, I was like, dude, I need to learn how. That's where it came from.
Bro, and North New Jersey and Brooklyn and Philly, like, everywhere. When it's hot outside, cats out there doing all type of crazy stuff. I remember one time, it's this park in New Jersey called Bellsburg Park. And I was with my boy Al, and we had a Diamante back then, listening to John B, right, at the park, trying to be cool. And these dudes were on bikes, right? We called ourselves, you know, trying to, you know, talk to some chicks or whatever. The dudes came through with the bikes, it was over. They were gone. And one dude flipped his bike, and it broke up like glass, man. It's crazy.
I've been out to Bike Fest out that direction with the Rough Riders once or twice before, some international bike shows, and they had some Rough Rider conventions. So some crazy stuff out your way.
Yeah, man, it's cool. It always excites me. You know, I don't know how to ride a bike. I'm too crazy for a bike. So a car suits me well.
I hear that, man.
Yeah, but wow. So auto mechanic, but for really, you know, a stuntman, basically, a traveling one. Now, obviously you've been in the networking field, or you've been working with people for a while now. And as I said, every time I get a chance to, you know, talk to one of your team members or folks, it's always a joy and pleasure. What drew you to the quote unquote networking industry? How'd you get started?
Well, like 2008 is probably when I first really got into the network industry, due to the fact that I've always been, you know, I guess today's term, everybody's a hustler. I always had multiple streams of income, always doing stuff on the side. But with stunt riding, when I was earlier, you know, I'm 43 now, so when I was 21, I was laid up for like 16 months. And that's when if I didn't live at home with mom and dad, I would have lost everything. So then I started, like, I knew I wasn't giving up stunt riding, so I had to figure a way how to have a second stream of income. And so I knew some people in the network marketing industry that made, you know, stupid money. And I was like, man, if I could make a quarter over there, I had that just in case money. And that's basically where, you know, started like that. And it's funny, actually helped promote some like UFC fights, like ground and pound on the fairground stuff. But I learned right away, you're not in control of that. It's just like, long story short on my end, we had a big fight, but it had a snowstorm. Well, you can't sell tickets if no one shows up.
Right.
Like, well, this isn't a good idea. I can't have two incomes that I could lose instantly. So then one of my buddies that actually owned a fabrication shop that sponsored my stunt riding, he was in a network marketing, and I was talking to him, and he showed me the business plan. And it's funny, I laughed and told him to go jump off the side of a cliff. That crap doesn't work. 6 months later, call him up, dude, what you doing? I need to do this. I don't care. Teach me. And it went from there, you know. It's like, I've figured out how to talk to people, figure out that, you know, there were so many people looking for a second income, but, you know, really young kid, or, you know, hometown superstar, if you want to say that, on a stunt bike, had more ego than anybody I ever wanted to deal with. You know, I was king and no one else, you know. But I learned real quick, calmed myself down, and found that there was a way that, you know, I could build income on the road. It's kind of after that, I was, you know, kind of hooked of just figuring out what would fit me right, and, you know, find out, like, you know, it doesn't matter what you know, it's like how people look at you, and went from there.
Wow, it's crazy to hear that, because, you know, there's so many people who probably are watching right now who tried network marketing. Some were successful, moderately successful, some weren't successful, but to hear folks' story, you know, and see, like you say, you've always been a hustler, you've always looked for a second income, but at that time, if it wasn't for network marketing, you wouldn't be able to enjoy your love, you know?
Right.
Which is crazy. Wow. So we go from network marketing. What was your biggest run in the industry? What company?
Where I started at? I was with Market America. Well, realistically, I still am.
Okay.
You know, since 2008. And then, you know, I like doing that, but just, you know, like I said, just a little while ago, it's like, sometimes people don't care what you know. They look at your image. You know, they're always like, dude, you're the party guy. Had all these bike parties. It's not, what do you know about health and nutrition? Even though I could sit down at a table and, you know, diagnose your, what I can help you with. And they're like, what do you know? You know, you're not a doctor. You're not this and that. You know, you don't go to the gym. You're not the healthiest dude. And they're like, well, I beat that living crap out of my body constantly. I still walk without a limp. I'm doing something right.
But, right. You
know, it was so hard battling back and forth, figuring that out. But.
Wow. So you started in nutrition. So
then I try to follow the trends, you know, jumped on the bandwagon with CBD, you know, watch. And that's really like right before I think you and me actually met, I thought that was going to be it, you know, built a huge team like instantly. And then the state of Wisconsin made this big thing. Oh, CBD is illegal. Watch the team's order stop coming in. It's like, wait, these people don't know what they're talking about. But, like up and down, like you start going like, oh, this is gonna be great. This is it. Got it. See you guys. Next level. Maybe not.
Right. That's crazy how, you know, one of my mentors recently, he told me to watch the show Billionaires. I never watched it. And he said, you'll learn the difference between billions and power, because the state has power to shut stuff down sometimes, even though those jokers don't make a lot of money, but they have the power, you know, which is crazy. Wow. So crypto. One thing, you know, I love about this space, that it's, there's no rules yet. And even though we share stuff with one another, we share stuff with groups, I always like to tell people we're not investors. We don't sell annuities. We don't sell life insurance. We're not financial planners. We share stuff that folks would share at a pub or the cookout or something. And I'm happy about that because you guys share stuff with me. I share stuff with you guys. And so when you start playing in the crypto space, you know, and think about it, back in network marketing, to build it, you got to recruit, but you better be a damn good seller or a damn right. good team builder, okay? And you better have some money aside for auto ship, right? So what's the difference with UIGI and the platforms that we brought in or that we've shared with one another, rather?
The huge thing is, like, no meetings, no monthly requirements, and the shy people still do it. Like, I have some good friends that would never even look at doing network marketing with me. But, you know, started doing this. They started watching. I'm like, guys, you could just log on your computer. You never have to talk to me even. And they just started doing it. And, you know, people, you know, it's funny. You know, you always have those people. Money's not everything. But when you're just leveraging money, it's a whole nother level for people, because people start seeing a return right away. And, you know, people get stupid when they see a return. And it's like, hey, you're referring people. Oh, no, I'm not. Like, you just shared that with 7 people. That's called referring. No, it's not. Okay.
Yeah, that's crazy too. So even though they're making money, they tell their family members or friends, but they're still not doing network marketing. They're not referring, right?
Right.
It's crazy. And that's why, you know, I love what we do, because we would probably have even millions of people if they could understand that you don't have to refer people here to make any money. But I guess they still think that, you know, for whatever reason, you know, I know there's someone watching right now thinking that.
Right. They're listening like, Joe, you're lying. You're referring people. Like, no, you don't have to. Just try it. And the problem is, the ones that are not referring, the real quiet ones that are making money, are too quiet.
Right. I call them secret agents. They ain't saying shit.
Right.
It's almost like they're scared to tell people that they're making money. You know, but you said something, man, no meetings, bro. You don't understand how happy I am that I don't have to go to a meeting or do a PBR or a home meeting or I was meeting out, man. I was tapped out. I said to myself, I have to do one more. And I was with FES, which is a great company for credit repair. When I started FES, I think my credit was 550 something. Now I'm close to 760. Nice. Right now. Yeah, exactly. Right. And I started with them in 2019, 2020. But even with them, we had to do webinars because the pandemic set in. And as much as I love those folks in FES, I was tired of doing damn webinars, you know? Right. It's crazy. But now we call this the nomad life.
But it's funny. People want us to do webinars for, even though they don't want to go to a meeting. Hey, can you do it live and let's, you know, get people in front of people? Like, wait, I thought you didn't want that. But I just want everybody to know what we're really doing. It's like, dude, just let them look at it. Watch a video and they're making money.
Exactly. Wow. So see, this is good. I love when I have a chance to talk to the different ringers because everybody's story is different. I haven't had one story to sound the same. So with our platforms, we've had some ups and downs. Well, when I say ups and downs, it's interesting. I think with all the things we brought to the table, we really only lost one, and that was MTI, because that raggedy one, Crypto 300, that was still alive.
Can't believe it was still alive.
Like, I don't know how people are doing with that one. And even with the one that just, you know, did a little flip-flop, Tron Case, they didn't came back with Tron Case 2.0. I told them they could have it, you know. Right. I'm not messing with them. But we've been able to sustain some good stuff, man. For sure. And we have some happy people. It's thousands of happy people. And even though we, you know, there are times when people join us and they have no knowledge of what we're doing, you know, even with the lumps and bumps, the minor lumps and bumps, they're able to stick around and, you know, say, okay, great, what's next?
Right. You know, they're able to, like, you know, I have some friends that, like, I'm only putting 10 bucks in. They put 10 bucks in. By the end of the month, like, how do I do a next phase? How do I next platform? Like, I thought you only want to put 10 bucks in. Well, that one's working. What else you got?
Yeah. And as I mentioned to you prior to us talking, I just, you know, connected with some major, major, major players. We have some other stuff that we'll be rolling out within the next couple of days. That's awesome. It's the most stable thing I've ever seen in my life. And that's not overstating. It's incredible. So I can't wait for that one. So out of the ones, I always ask this question, which one's your favorite, you know, platform that we share across the bar? Which one's your favorite?
Right now, I'd have to say probably HyperFun. To the fact there was, you know, when we started doing it like 6 months ago, it's funny. I did a big whoops and invested way too much on it by pushing the wrong button, but whatever. It just, the system's so, makes so much money, the system's so easy to do. Like, you know, it's just really one click every day, one click. And it's like, there's no, you know, when you try to explain it to somebody, it's just like, you know, take part in it and you, one click, really, you know, it's hard to explain without, you know, showing the back office, but I really like the HyperFun one. And
I like HyperFun too. You know, you and I were mentioning earlier, you know, the owners, these guys are, they're billionaires, and they did a promo or something. They talked about them on Amazon Prime, you know, that HyperFun is solid. And I give HyperFun, you know, I give everybody my 1 to 10, my scale of 1 to 10. You know, I gave Tron Case a 7. I give HyperFun a solid 9, you know, a good 9. You know, some people give them 11. I give them a good 9. I like them. And they're making us a whole bunch of money. You know, go HyperFun.
That's fun. Right now I can think about the platforms. I can't even think about what platforms they are. I just got a list. I just go in every day, 10 minutes, click, withdraw, reinvest. You know, it's silly.
Yeah, and think about that. One of my boys, like, he was recently hanging out with me. Actually, he came with me to Dubai, and we were sitting there, and I had to do all other type of work, but my easy work was waking up, pushing some buttons, taking my money out, you know, and keeping it rolling.
Right.
And it's a wonderful thing, man. Mm. So I can't wait. I'm going to run this by the ringer. I won't say it now publicly, but, you know, we have a location. Actually, we have a location that we had all agreed on, which was Arizona. But, brother, my wife and I just came from a place that I think everybody would love. I'll run it by you guys. Y'all, we'll stick with Arizona, you know, because they voted Arizona over Vegas. But this other place, I might have to show y'all videos and stuff of it. I think everybody would probably want to go. It's incredible.
Just do it in February. Everybody will pick anywhere as warm up.
Yeah, right. Hell, we might do another one in February. Who knows, you know? Wow, so I can't wait. And, you know, I just today, the mock-ups came for the ring. So they've been sending me samples. The mock-ups are incredible. They're wax, but right. They're so detailed, you know. You know when you're on some different stuff. Even my wife and I, we purchased her engagement ring and, you know, rings in the past. No one made a mock-up. You know, you went to K Jewelers, you just grabbed a ring, you know? Yeah, these things are amazing. They're putting a lot of their heart, you know, heart and soul into this thing for us too. So I like the jeweler, man. So we found out what's your favorite. Here's a question I ask, because I thought that we found the best mousetrap. And what do I mean by that? I thought we found what people love. You know, no recruiting, no sales. You know, no startup costs, no monthlies. And still, there's some people who are so excited about these darn tokens and coins out there. They're like, yeah, Abu, that's all nice. I'll take a gamble on a token. What's your experience on that? What have you been seeing in the marketplace with that phenomenon?
I could just like this. It's gambling, man. It's gambling. It's like, you know, let's see, 4 weeks ago, maybe 5 weeks ago, 48 hours, like over 200,000 gain. And by the time you figure out how to pancake swap this and that, I think I'm negative $2,000 right now. So it's just like, how do you want to say it? If you want to live the life we did when we first launched Daisy, yeah, I forgot about Daisy. Like I said, that's a great platform too. That's another one that, it's there. I forget about it because I don't do anything with it.
Absolutely.
And have made stupid money in there. But yeah, chasing coins, you have no life, dude. It's like people don't realize you got to be up when China wakes up, because they're going to buy and sell and trade, and you're going to wake up at 5 or 6 in the morning and be like, dude, I had a huge gain at 1 a.m. when I was sleeping. But it already dropped by the time you wake up. So chasing coins, you can't sleep. I'm not going to lie. When I made a lot of money here, I was like, hey, I'm going for that quick buy over there and try to, import these coin addresses. And like, everybody's like, this is the way to make it. Like, well, I'll try it, whatever. Yeah, no. I already do enough stuff that I don't sleep at night. You can't have it's work. Day trading is day trading for a reason. Cryptocurrency, that's 24-hour trading. You can't be human.
Absolutely. I agree, man. It's crazy. That's why, we have copy pro traders. Let them cats do what they do, And we have something that's coming out soon, within the next couple of days, that's just as solid as copy pro traders. The difference is it's only $99 a year, So we'll keep copy pro traders, but this is solid as well. So I'm excited about that too, man. So we got some things coming down the pipe. What we're finding is people bringing stuff to us that's more and more stable, you know, with sick returns still, but more and more stable, and people bring stuff to me every 2 seconds. I know what happens to you as well, man. Yeah. Oh my God. Like, if we jump on everything, we be gambling like we're jumping on coins. It's crazy. Yeah. But it's gratifying, man, to see so many people winning. Now, I don't know about you, but when I was in network marketing for all those years, 97% of people didn't win. This is the flip.
97, you must have had a good team. I thought like 99.4%. Oh yeah.
It's crazy. But we could say here, like literally, like 90 plus, if they're sticking around, they're making money.
Right. If they're playing even everywhere, they're making money. Even the ones that don't play even, I haven't really had someone pull out black and white, say, dude, unless it just happened, overnight or something went bad. But, it's like, dude, you can't even count if you've only been around for a week. Like, go do the stock market. You can't win overnight in the stock market.
Right. Right.
Give yourself 6 months at least, 12 months. But.
And even though we say give yourself 6 to 12 months, you can make it here in 3 months, literally. Like you said, if it's spread even, So speaking of that, the one-third rule. I love the one-third rule for a couple of reasons. One, it keeps people safe. But do you and your group, or do they love the one-third rule?
They love it if they follow it.
Right.
I kind of play that basis off and getting, if people want my advice, I'm kind of like you. I don't give people advice. I just share it to them. If they actually reach out to me personally, and I know their history, I do switch around to them, like do the 50-50 if you want to make, I never do 100%. I don't do 100% on myself,
Oh, no.
Even when you have extra money, it's like, no, you think about it. And it's like, oh, this would be sweet. This math is crazy right here. But, the people that follow something, at least 50 or a third, they're winning.
I agree. But the super gambler ones, those are the ones who get ticked off. Right.
As excited as they get, as mad as they get. So you can't be on both sides of the fence playing that way.
Right. My accountant, he's the one who heads up 7K medals with us. And he always says something. Pigs get fed and hogs get slaughtered.
Right.
When you're greedy, you're gone. You're dead in the water. So, wow, man, this is cool.
And sometimes, I guess, in the nicest way, they might have to lose to learn that we're not joking when we say the third. I've been there. There's been a platform or two that wasn't involved with us. Said, hey, this could be a quick 7 days. Yeah, right.
Man, oh my God, the Wordomizers of the world, the All Bullishes of the world. Man, they've come and taken money and then disappeared. It's crazy.
Lambo's in 2 days. Yeah, right.
Yeah, right. So as we round this up, man. So I'm a brand new person who joined UIGI. I don't know how I found it. Maybe a friend of mine introduced me. What would you say to me as someone brand new who joined our Facebook group, our social club, and they're looking to maybe make some money for themselves.
Well, right away when I, say if you're new or whatever, I'm like, what are you looking to get out of this? You know, are you looking to, make a couple hundred bucks a month? Are you looking, are you looking to change your life? And, talk to you, see, try to figure out if you're, telling the truth or whatever. And going from there, then, how much money you want to start, can you afford to put out there right now? And if they say $100, like if you say $100, I'm break it down to you first. Say, remember, if you're saying $100, $100 means a lot to you. So you're going to be excited when you make $17 that first month.
That's right.
$100 means a lot to you. $17 gain is huge to you. But, if you're doing 10 grand and making $17, you're going to be excited.
That's right.
I try to break it down to you as in you can't compare what you heard about me. We got to talk about what's going to change, what's going to make you excited to stay around. Because if you're excited, you're going to stay around and you're going to make a lot of money. If you're not excited, it doesn't matter what I'm saying. And you got to be smart on the percentage you're doing because, you're not going to put $100 in Rabu and, make $99 in 30 days. That's not realistic.
That's not happening nowhere.
Right.
Right. Wow.
So feel you out and see, make you understand, money gains, what's realistic and what's not a pipe dream.
Gotcha.
You make dreaming money here, but you got to work to it.
I agree 110%. And I tell people also, the referral games helps accelerate everything, but you don't have to, but it puts some fire behind it, and people end up doing it anyway. One thing that, I pride myself in saying, and this is not even a disclaimer, it's just the real deal, for those who are watching, again, as I mentioned, we're not financial planners. We don't have licenses. We don't do any of that stuff. Some people share some stuff with us in the crypto space, and we share with other people and they share with us every day. We share with other people every day. And it's a wonderful thing. But also we have Amazon stores and Walmart stores that are rocking, and people are loving those as well. So, and we have precious metals that are rocking, people are loving those as well. We try to make sure that if people are going to play with us and they have some money to play with, not invest, but to play with, we show them enough things that, that's been shared with us. We share with them and, people rock and roll.
Right.
It's pretty awesome. So, hey man, I'm excited for you, man. It's been cool. For those who are watching right now, Joseph, you can tell by his demeanor, he don't play any games. He knows his stuff. He has a large group, that are doing extremely well. They play very conservative. Every once in a while, someone jumps over the fence. It is what it is. But follow him, inbox him, reach out to him. You can learn a lot from him. He's been in a people game for a long time. Now he's in the money game and the people game. And he's helping his folks do extremely well. So make sure you inbox him. He has an Instagram page as well. It's pretty cool too. If you like stunts, check out his Instagram page. But reach out to him, follow him. Ask him about UIGI. Ask him how you could be part of this social club too and play around also and make some money. So, hey man, it's been a pleasure, brother. Any last words for the folks before we close out?
No, I just tell people, reach out to me. I'll share everything I have. There's no secrets here. Mm-hmm. There's no stuff that we all been trained in the back. It's money in, money out, click buttons.
And that's I love it. All right, man. Well, cool, bro. I'm about to go get me something to eat. I'm starving. Okay. I've been away, as you know, for a month. I'm home after a month, 3 weeks in Dubai, a week in Florida. I'm doing laundry and eating right now. So.
Living on the road for a month's tough on you.
Oh man, it sucks. I'm back.
Doesn't matter how nice that hotel is. Nothing's like home.
Nah, you never can. Man, the last hotel we were in, and we stayed at nice hotels, but this one was like a beach hotel, and they have one of those little air conditioners right under the window that make all the damn noise in the world. Oh my God, I hate those things. Oh man. All right, man. Well, I'm gonna let you go, man. Congrats. Thanks, man. I appreciate you. Again, congrats, big time. One of our newest Millionaire Club Circle earners. Again, can't wait to put that ring on your finger. In October, we already have the dates. But in October, man, we're gonna have a good time.
All right, cool, man. Can't wait.
All right, bro. See you later on.
Thanks.
Peace.